KitCon South Gujarat, 13-14 April 2019 at Surat. Healthcare Technology Conference for Doctors, by Doctors. Powered by Management Medicals.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Dr. Kalia. I'm Vice President with TriStar Group of Hospitals. Dr. Alok Ranjan told you how to lose money. I will tell you how to earn money using technology. So there's a little difference. At TriStar, we give 360-degree solution. We also make you lose money, and then we also tell you how to earn the money. So my presentation would be about startups. You must be seeing it on the net. There are a lot of startups that are coming up, especially in healthcare, using technology. So my presentation is going to revolve around how technology can be leveraged to earn money, right? We see a lot of entrepreneurs. Gujarat is a land of entrepreneurs, right? Especially, and when it comes to healthcare, we see a lot of entrepreneurs. In Surat, there are a lot of hospitals coming up, single doctor, group of doctors coming up together to start. So these are all entrepreneurs. But the only difference is that we haven't leveraged the technology aspect as far as healthcare is concerned. We are coming up with brick and mortar startups, right? So this presentation is going to be about how we can use technology to do a startup, right? So let us start with the presentation. So what are the opportunities in healthcare? How can technology be used to make money? I would like to ask you, let's keep this presentation a little interactive. Would anybody tell me what is the difference? Hello? Can you hear me? So can anybody tell me what is the difference between a startup and a normal business that we do? What is the difference? When you talk about startups, you must have heard about Practo. Practo is a startup. So what is the difference between Practo and somebody who starts a medical shop? Both are entrepreneurs. But what is the basic difference as far as the words are concerned? Entrepreneurship and having a startup, both are entrepreneurs, both are starting a business. What is the basic difference? Anybody? Oh, no, no, that's okay. Okay, anybody else? Okay, maybe some aspect of it. So when we come to a startup, I tell you what is the basic difference between a simple entrepreneur. So what happens is, I start a hospital. It's a standalone hospital. I started in Surat. It is a startup. It is an entrepreneur, this thing. But it doesn't have scalability, right? So when we have scalability, right, you understand when I say scalability is that the same model can be adapted to the rest of the country, either by the use of technology or not by the use of technology. Technology is an important component because it makes everything scalable, you know, and viable. It has to be scalable and viable. So Practo is scalable, right? By using technology, they have presence in almost 18-20 countries, right? In no time, within a year, within 10 years, they've almost expanded throughout the world. But if we start a hospital in one town, it is not that. So the basic difference between an entrepreneur and a startup is the scalability and the viability of the model. Like OYO rooms, right? Go IBGO, Make My Trip. These are all scalable models. So that is why they are termed as, definitely they are technologically savvy. But their Apollo hospitals, at a point of time, it was a startup and now expanded across the country. So that is a good startup that has come up well. So that is the basic difference we need to understand. So my talk is going to revolve around how we can use technology to make some startups in healthcare ecosystem. So we need to understand. So there is a journey. This talk I delivered in one of the universities. A lot of young entrepreneurs were there. So all these guys from IITs, NITs, they come to us. They tell us that you tell me the gap in the healthcare system and I will make a solution for it. Okay. Now, most of the people after graduating, doing their MBBS or MDs, they look at starting a clinic, right? But for doing a startup, you need a little macro vision, right? How can I make a product which can deliver solutions across the world, across the country, across the state, right? A little bit of PSM into it. There is a very good software that we people are using in the civil hospital for immunization. Sir, if you can help me with the name. there are a lot of technological advancement even the government is using now. So we will go during the course, we will study. So opportunities in healthcare space, a lot of opportunities. So how do you identify ki mujhe startup kaun sa karna hai? How do I identify ki space kaha hai? Healthcare mein, suppose I decide that I am not going to go into a brick and mortar model. Okay, I am not going to start a clinic, purchase a land, construct a hospital, run it 24/7 and then take all the hassle. Or I am going to build a technologically smart model which will help all the hospitals across the country or all the patients across the country and maybe the world. So your thought process has to change. The way you look at problem has to change. It is not a single mohalla, single city, single town, single district thought. Your thought has to be pan-Indian. Your thought has to be how to make a difference to the healthcare community through the use of technology, right? So starting a startup, there are a lot of principles, management principles that are required to, I think our ancestors always knew these principles. We have a lot of entrepreneurs in Gujarat especially. So, but let me put it in little English language and tell you that what are the various steps. How do you identify the space, the gaps in the system, and then how do you build a solution for it, right? So I'll also like to take a small case study of one of the healthcare startups. I was lucky that be that be Portia, be that be Flipkart, be that be HealthyFi.me, and a lot of these. So Flipkart owner Sachin Bansal was my school senior. HealthyFi.me team, he's also from the same school. We are all alumni of the same school. So we have seen it all. We have seen it growing up. We have seen all these startups from day one, how these startups came up. And so I can tell you very closely, I've lived very closely with it, I've followed it up over the last 8-10 years. I can tell you what are the journey and what are the challenges as far as healthcare startups are concerned. There are no there is no magic trick, there is no formula for success. There is no late path. I mean, now we look at, let us suppose HealthyFi.me or even Pacto. And we look at say, you have to do something like this, then only you will be successful. No, the technology is changing very fast. Probably they did not imagine that they would take this path. Okay, now you look back and see that there was a model that these people took and now you see that they are successful. So people might tell you that this is the way to success, but in technology, there is no way to success. You have to create your own way. So the healthcare industry is growing. People have already talked about Internet of Things, how machines talk to each other, artificial intelligence, big data analytics, virtual reality. I'm going to tell you how startups have been dealing. A lot of startups that you see these days, 82% of the startups in healthcare system are focusing on how to increase the quality of outcomes or the delivery to the patient, right? 78% are looking at the accessibility, how to make healthcare accessible, okay? And 60% are there to say how to make it more affordable, right? So Practo is a simple example. The way they did it, they have improved the accessibility of the doctors. Taking an appointment was a difficult task, getting the number of the doctor was a difficult task. Now they made an app, you go to Practo, you take an appointment, the doctor is accessible. You know the information that doctor is available, or the when the doctor is available, what is the clinic address. All these things they have made accessible and affordable. Right? The anatomy of healthcare startups. So these are the various startups that are happening at the world level. So Mindspace or Brainsgate, these are various startups. Now they are working using AI technology, using virtual reality, and using medical sciences. So generally in a startup, you need an engineer. You need somebody from the IT background, you need a medical doctor, maybe a neurologist. They both have to combine, bring their energies together and bring out a solution. So we take a small example. Like for example, I was very keen on, so I used to see that CT scans, MRIs. So for example, a CT scan center would operate for 8 to 8 maybe, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m.
Sir, right? You have 2 minutes only. No. So, we need a startup to solve this problem, that is true. Yes. So I don't think this talk can be finished in that time. But so let me give you the basic principles of how startups are to be done. So I think the basic principle is identifying a problem. Let us take a small example because you have to understand that appointment in a CT scan or MRI center was a big challenge. So there are some boys, NIT, SVNIT, only they are working with us. We are helping them how to sort this problem. So they are basically building an app, right? It's a real-time app, just like Ola. Okay, so they are going to shortly come to all CT scan centers. They're going to find out, you just have to update that today we have an appointment from 8 to 8:30. Between 8:30 to 9:30, the slot is free. Okay, so the CT scan centers don't have a patient at that time, and so they are going to tell the patient that you are going to get 50% discount, which is going to be offered by the diagnostic centers also, because the machine is free, or the machine is free after, let us suppose, 9:30 or 10 o'clock in the evening to morning. So to optimum utilization of the resources, and the patients can get same things in a very less amount. So that is, these are the few startups that are actually coming out of Surat. There are a lot of guys, they always involve a person from the medical background. So we incubate all these startups, we help them as far as this is concerned. So this is the way technology can be leveraged, and money can be saved, healthcare can be made more accessible and affordable. There are a lot of slides to it, but I think today is not the, so we don't have appropriate time for it. Thank you so much, sir. That's it.
Okay. Thank you.
HitCon South Gujarat, 13-14 April 2019 at Surat. Healthcare Technology Conference for doctors by doctors. Powered by Management Medicals.